Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Imam Hassan, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Today is an interesting video. It's off of Nikah series. It's actually talking about, we're going to talk about fades in Islam. Can a guy get a fade haircut in Islam? This is a requested video by one of my good friends, so I couldn't refuse. All right, can we get fades? A fade is when you have different lengths of hair on different places of your head. For example, you might have it shorter on the side and longer on top. Is that permissible in Islam? Point number one, everything is permissible until and unless proven impermissible. This is the default rule as proven by many, many different verses. I'll say one hadith. The Prophet says, Allah has made things halal clearly and made things haram clearly, and he has stayed silent on things intentionally as a mercy for us. Meaning those things which are not explicitly haram, they are halal. Point number two, well, then why do some scholars say it's haram? There is a hadith which is utilized to say, well, this hadith is making it haram. And that hadith is a small boy was brought to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he had a haircut called Qaza, and we'll talk about that. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbade from that haircut, meaning the Prophet said, don't do that, right? Either leave all of it or cut all of it. Now, based off of this one hadith, what does the word qaza' mean? As the narrator of the hadith says, it means, now the one asking the question, he is a slave of Ibn Umar, and he was not an Arab by descent. So he's asking, what does this word mean? So he's asking a linguistic definition. And he says, he gives him a generic answer. It's to cut some and to leave some. Qaza' linguistically means patches of hair, meaning it's all scattered in patches. Like a clear sky which has patches of cloud in different places. That's exactly how that kid's head was looking. Hair all over the place and missing all over. The Prophet said, either cut all or leave all. What is this? Right? So why was it forbidden? Why did the Prophet ﷺ say don't do it? Well, obviously, the Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi, he mentions three obvious reasons. Number one, he mentions that it was a adalul ashtara. Ashatara, right? He says, Ashtara, which means that it was the way of the people who were unaccepted in society. Meaning it was the way, it looked completely indecent and a person looked terrible. So they were standing out abnormally. Number two, Imam Nawawi mentions Zayil Yahud. This was the practice of the Jewish people to fight off superstition. So they would shave their kids' heads and make them look ugly. Right, as same thing mentioned in the first point, you look indecent and ugly. So they would shave their kids' hair off in random places to make them look ugly, right? So they don't get nadhar. And the Prophet ﷺ said, no, don't do it. That has nothing to, you can't save nadhar from that. Nadhar is actually, some people don't have any intention of giving nadhar. It's just the power of some people's eye and you get it, right? That's why you should always read your du'as. Imam Nawawi mentions a third thing and he says, tashwihul khalq. It is to completely make yourself look ugly. Right? It's completely ruining the natural beauty Allah has given you of you having your hair and you're making yourself look completely ugly. All three things mean one thing. You look ugly. You look unacceptable. You look, when somebody looks at you, they don't even want to look at you. And that's not even subjective. It's objective. It's a societal thing. You look objectively indecent in society. That was the reason the Prophet ﷺ he forbade from that. Right? And opposite to that, the Prophet says, Inna Allah jamil yuhibbul jamal. Allah is beautiful. He loves beauty. And this was sent, this hadith of beauty was said in context of clothing and presentation. Now, Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi, in his sharah of Imam Muslim, right? He quotes, he says, the scholars are unanimous. Now check this out. They are unanimous that when qaza, it's in its most ugliest form of patches, even then the ruling is not haram. It's not even makruh tahrimi, which is also sinful. It's makruh tanzihi, which is not sinful, but it's something that you should avoid. Imam Malik goes on further and he says, no, this is only for adolescents before the age of puberty, meaning for little kids, right? After that, the ruling doesn't even apply to anyone. And in the Hanafi madhab, it is permissible to have differences, right? Variations in hair length up to 3 fingers. So no one understood this hadith to mean uneven haircuts. And whoever is twisting and turning this hadith to mean that is completely going against the grain of what all the scholars have classically said. Lastly, I'll end off with an incident from Sahih Bukhari to prove that uneven haircuts are not impermissible. Abu Mahdura is one of the four companions of the Prophet who accepted Islam and gave the Adhan, one of the four. He was the one in Mecca. This happened towards the end of the conquest of Mecca. He was a little boy and the Adhan was happening, and he started with his friends mocking the Adhan, and the Prophet called these boys over and the Prophet said, "Who has the loudest voice?" And the Prophet already knew who was the one mocking, and they said, "Abu Mahdura," right, this boy. And the Prophet said, you're the one, right? So the Prophet ﷺ put his hand on his head and he says, "Repeat the Adhan." And he said, "Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar." When he got to Ashhadu La ilaha illallah, he said it softly. And likewise, when he got to Ashhadu Anna Muhammad Rasulullah, he said it softly. He was not a Muslim at that time. And they were into shirk, right? Multiple gods. They didn't believe in a Prophet. So the Prophet grabbed his head strongly where his hand was and he says, "Say it louder, boy." And he said, "I felt faith, iman going into me." Long story short, Abu Mahdura said, because of the barakah of that day, that moment, I never cut that portion, that of my hair off. If it was impermissible, unequivocally, a sahabi would never do anything haram open in the public. And no other sahabis forbade him for that either, right? So from this, we understand that it is absolutely permissible. Last but not least, well, is it from the ways of the kuffar? مَن تَشَبَّهَ بِكَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ. This hadith, whoever resembles a nation is from them, is talking about resembling the kuffar, the people who disbelieve in their traits of kufr, which actually signify kufr, which actually demonstrate kufr, which actually represent kufr. A haircut does not represent kufr. Maybe you know how some Buddhists might have their tail, that's a haircut that represents kufr. The yarmulke represents kufr. Because otherwise, we wouldn't be allowed to wear clothing like jeans and t-shirt and all of that, right? It's Western clothing, but when it comes to haircut, we say kufar haircut. Do we say kufar clothing? No, we say Western clothing. It has nothing to do with faith, but rather a place on the map, right? Just the West of the world does this. Likewise for this haircut. So this haircut does not mean you are following the kufar in this in any way, sense, or form. This was for the guys, right? Obviously, girls, it is impermissible for girls to have their haircut, above their shoulders. And inshallah, there's going to be a series after this nikah series. It's the fiqh of fashion. And inshallah, we'll be talking about everything that you guys want to hear in terms of haircuts, clothing, nail polish, jewelry, and all of that. But I wanted to do this for a friend. He definitely requested it, so I couldn't refuse. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.